So I always kept to myself, never got into trouble in most of my school days, with the exception of this one day in around 1970, the day of the great green pea caper. It was a typical day where all the kids would break for lunch. I got one of those school lunches, which consisted of what was considered a well-balanced meal at the time, on a heavy-duty rectangular plastic tray, just like the ones you see in the Fallout games, with an assortment of various food items, each separated in their own compartment indentations in this tray. I don't remember what the main course was, but I do remember one of the sides, the infamous green peas. So there I was, sitting at one of those long folding cafeteria tables with various other kids, trying to quietly eat my lunch. And then it happened. I took my fork and attempted to stab some peas for consumption purposes. The thing about peas, though, is that they are round and have a tendency to avoid fork stabbing. With the kinetic energy produced by my fork stabbing, one of the peas escaped to the confines of the indentation on my plastic lunch tray and landed on the table. I couldn't eat my lunch now. I was sitting there staring at this green pea on the table. That pea was a monument, a symbol of my failure to properly eat my peas with a fork. It was so embarrassing, and it was there for everyone to see. I had to do something. Then I realized that there was a gap between two of the kids across the table from me. That was my chance. Quickly, quietly, I flicked this pea onto the floor between those two kids. Thank goodness I was able to hide my pea-eating disability. What a relief. But it didn't go unnoticed. One of the kids sitting across from me, that was to the right of that pea receiving gap, was one of those extremely outgoing kids. He saw his opportunity. He takes his fork and he pretends to accidentally knock a pea off his tray. And he insincerely says, "Whoops," for additional effect, and chuckles. Then, instead of flicking the pea off the table like I did, he proceeds to send it down the length of the table so that all the other kids could see this pea flying by in front of them. Suddenly, the table turned into an experiment of nuclear fission. Another kid from the other end of the table shot a pea down the length of the table from the other direction. The next thing I knew, there was this chain reaction of peas flying back and forth down the table. I did not participate in this. Again, I was embarrassed. I just wanted to finish my lunch and wait for the end of lunch bell to ring. So there I was, eating my lunch with green high velocity streaks zipping across in front of me, when all of a sudden, one of the lunch ladies came to the table and started yelling for the kids to stop. The peas suddenly stopped flying. I was still trying to finish my lunch. I still had my peas on my plate. For all the other kids, they didn't have their peas anymore. I had my peas on my plate. I was still eating them. But the lunch lady had one question. Who started this? Oh my God. It was like the scene from a horror movie. All the kids at the table, in what seemed to be in one synchronous motion, turned and pointed my direction. I was thrown under the school bus, so to speak, by my fellow classmates. Any defensive explanation I came up with was ignored. So I had to accept my fate as being the one who started it. And I was delivered to the principal's office to receive the finest corporal punishment the public school system had to offer at that time. And I remember it like it was yesterday. Principal says, "Bend over, touch your ankles." And he brought out this wooden paddle with the holes drilled into it, I guess to, you know, add to the aerodynamics, and swatted me in the butt with it. There you go.
Hey, wait up. One sec. I got some news. The Beastie Boys are coming out with a new anthology. It's coming in 5 parts. Parts A through D are absolutely free. However, you have to fight for your right to Part E.
What if we have a son and he wants to take dance class even though all his friends are playing football?
He can dance if he wants to. He can leave his friends behind. Because his friends don't dance, and if they don't dance, then they're no friends of mine.
Yeah, back when I was in 4th grade years ago. God, that was a long time.
I laugh because...
I can't believe I'm almost 30!
I'm only 18. I feel like I'm 30, though, if that counts. I love donuts.
What's the time for y'all?
My body aches like it.
Yeah.
Wait till you get to 28.
I love donuts. Says I am 18 as well.
No, I'm not looking forward to it.
Oh, I can't remember when I was 28. That was a long time ago.
Oh, come on, damn it! Just trying to play.
Hey, how old are you?
Do you really want to know?
Yes. Spill the beans.
60.
You...
What?
Hold on.
That's a lot.
Yeah.
You're 60?
Yes, I am.
The youngest here.
You
MCG says it uses 5 trillion.
Yeah, I know.
78,374,427,090. You may not sleep now. Exactly. There are monsters nearby.
All right, let's take a look at the socials and see what friends I have online. Okay, there's one. She's blue in the come join me mode, and she's in the friends plus world. Cool. I'll head right on over there. Hey, what's up?
Hey, what are you doing here? This is a private conversation.
If no one has told you that they loved you today, then I'm not going to be the first person to do it. I don't know you. You could be a terrible person, which could be the reason why no one's told you that they loved you today.
I could be brown, I could be blue, I could be violet sky, I could be hurtful, I could be purple, I could be anything you like. I could be brown, I could be blue, I could be violet sky, I could be hurtful, I could be purple, I could be anything you like. I could be brown, I could be blue, I could be violet sky, I could be hurtful, I could be purple, I could be anything you like. I could be brown, I could be blue, I could be violet sky, I could be hurtful, I could be purple, I could be anything you like. I could be brown, I could be blue, I could be violet sky, I could be hurtful, I could be purple, I could be anything you like. I could be brown, I could be blue, I could be violet sky, I could be hurtful, I could be purple, I could be anything you like.
Hi, I'm the Progressive Geek, and I'm looking for more followers to my channel. And to convince you that you need to follow me, I'm going to tell some jokes. Why did the protege fall into the well? Because he couldn't see that well. Here's another one. When I found out my toaster wasn't waterproof, I was shocked. I started a business teaching Diwali math. I call my business Making the Little Things Count. Did you hear about the slime tatum that evaporated? He will be missed.
Hope everybody's having a better day than me. Let me tell you how my day is going so far. So you may or may not notice that for some reason, I'm blue. Why am I blue? Well, let me tell you. So while cleaning up a mess of ink today, a little bit of it got on my hands, which then made its way onto my face. However, that's not the end of the story. So I, immediately after doing this and unaware of how I was looking, had to pee. So not only are my hands and my face stained this way, my wiener's blue.
Always think the best, you always thought I have a life I could grow with you. But as time fades, crazy how our lives change, feeling like a shockwave without you. Always think the best, you always thought I have a life I could grow with you. But as time fades, crazy how our lives change, feeling like a shockwave without you. Always think about you, always thought I had a life I could grow with you. As time fades, crazy how our lives change, feeling like a shockwave without you.
When someone asks me how much I have spent on my dog.
700 billion and a trillion 300 million billion dollars.
Were you looking at this? Hmm? No, don't try and deny it. It's already too late. You were caught. Shame on you.
This is nuts. How do I stop this train? I want to get off. Okay, I'm going to answer this question. What's a ship you claim from any game, movie, or show? And the ship I claim is this one. This one likes to fly away. It is Serenity. It is a Firefly class ship from a show by the same name, Firefly. And I think it is a pretty cool ship. It was a toss-up between this one and Andromeda. But I think I'll claim this ship. Sorry, what's that? Not that kind of ship? Relation? What? No. Well, the question said ship. So this is the ship I claim. And I am standing by it. Cool. Officer's log, stardate 4113.8. I'm in a secret underground Starfleet lab working on an unsanctioned project. The goal is to produce a tough, intelligent creature that can augment personnel on dangerous away missions. I obtained a special sample of DNA from the black market on planet Gumroad. This DNA from a race of Rexolium with a distinctive red panda coloring. I read some old research notes that suggested that even though the Rexolium evolved is not technically related to the basic Rexolium, the coloring DNA may be compatible. I have integrated this Rexolium panda DNA into my test subject, who is from the Rexoium evolved species. I'm about to review the results.